Hello students, so now we will be starting with our next chapter, which is religion and society. In the last lecture we have already covered the relations of sociology with various social sciences, in which we have covered relations of sociology with psychology, philosophy and economics. But before continuing with the same topic and comparing sociology with other social sciences, we will first study the comparison between religion and other religion, and the relation between religion and society, and the comparison between religion and science. So we will be starting with our next lecture, that is chapter 8 of your paper 1, religion and society. Now before jumping towards the first topic of the religion and society chapter, that is sociological theories of religion, we'll first understand what do you mean by religion. So religion, as all people know, that it is related to the beliefs, practices, the dogmas, the thinking about the things that a person considered to be sacred, and or you can say the things which you consider as spiritual, or which is related with the divine or supernatural being. So you can write the definition of religion. Religion is the system of dogmas, beliefs, rituals and practices related to the things which are considered as sacred, or you can say as spiritual. So James Fraser, an anthropologist, has defined religion in a very good language, or he has imparted very good meaning to religion. As per him, religion is the set of beliefs and practices, or the power. You can say religion is considered to be the power, as per, you can say, James Fraser. Religion is the power which controls the universe. So this universe consists of the man and the other inanimate things. Man, you can say plants, animals, plus other inanimate things. So this is the definition which is given by the Fraser. Now, as you think that religion is found in each and every society, you can say in ancient society as well as modern society, in pre-literate society and in industrial civilized society, religion is found in each and every society since the time immemorial. And you can say religion basically is used to answer those questions which man considers to be beyond its comprehension or beyond its control. So to answer those questions, man used to understand the answers of those questions with the help of religion. So as we were discussing that it is always a curiosity in the mind of person to know the meaning of life and to know its place in the universe, to understand the universe, what are the different forces there in the universe and how come they are controlling the man and the society, not only the man but the entire society. So because people are not cannot control the nature, or the nature is out of the beyond the control of the human being, so man considered that there is a force or supernatural force which is sitting over and above the individual, or over the above the society, which is control not only the individual but also the society. So and this is the definition which is given by the different evolutionary sociologists, that there is a force, supernatural force, which is controlling the individual, and they, and that is why the individual considers that force to be the part of religion. Now you should understand that religion is not only about visiting the church or visiting the temple. It is about the various practices which a person do perform to fulfill the rites of any religious activity. So religion is not only about the attendance in the church or attendance in the temple, but it is also about the various beliefs and practices, but it is also about the various thought processes, like which guide an individual in the society. For example, you can say the dharma, or what is the dharma of the person, what is the meaning of the life of the person, why a person is being has got birth on this earth. So to answer these questions, or what is the meaning of virtue, what is the meaning of sin, so those type of questions which guide a person's life, those moral values are answered by religion. So you can say religion is not only about the attendance in the church and the beliefs and practices, but it also is a moral force in the society which is guiding the different people, the people life which are living in the society. Plus, you can say the different festivals or different feasts, and you can say the various religious practices, you can say they are composed of different feasts and festivals, the various meditation processes, initiation processes, and you can say the presence of omnipresent God, and you can say the funeral ceremonies, the different ceremonies, and so you can say these all practices and beliefs are part of, you can say, the part of religion. Now it is the curiosity of sociologists also, because I have already explained that religion is found in every society. So it is the task of sociologists, and it is also their curiosity to understand the different forms of religion which is existing in different societies. Sociologist does not want to know that why religion has been evolved, or why religion has been existing in the world, but because it is existing, so it wants to know how does man think about the existence of religion and the different forms of religion and the practices which is performed by the man to perform the religious activity. So it does not want to know the origin of religion, but actually it wants to know, if the religion is existing, then why man considers that activity to be a part of religion, and how does man think religion existing, the different forms in which religion is existing in society. So in this case, it is pertinent to understand the definition which is given by the sociologist whose name is Imail Durkheim. So what does Imail Durkheim says? So he says that religion is a system of so now here it is pertinent here to understand the definition of religion given by Imail Durkheim. So you already know that Imail Durkheim is a functionalist, and is a renowned functionalist of France, belongs to France. So what he says about religion, he says that religion is a unified system of beliefs and practices related to sacred things, which are set apart and forbidden. Beliefs and practices which unite into a single moral community called church, all those who adhere to them. So this is the definition given by Malcolm King. So he says that religion is a system of beliefs and practices. So according to him, those beliefs and practices which are related to sacred things. Sacred means the one. So sacred means extraordinary. You can say sacred means extraordinary. The one which inspires wonder. जिसको आपको लगता है कि कोई वंडरफुल चीज है, कोई वंडर है, कोई आश्चर्य है, विच इंस्पायर्स वंडर एंड सेड टू बी लिंक्ड टू द डिवाइन. दिस इज सेक्रेट, यू सेड विच इज लिंक्ड टू द डिवाइन. दिस इज द मीनिंग ऑफ सेक्रेट एज पर दुखी. Dukhin, religion is a system of beliefs and practices which are related to sacred things. Sacred things which are set apart, sacred you already understand, which are set apart and forbidden. Set apart and forbidden means which cannot, which you have to set apart from your daily life, or which are untouched from the daily life of people, or which you cannot. So I was explaining the Durkheim's concept of religion. So basically Durkheim's definition of religion is a unified system of beliefs and practices relative to sacred things which are to be set apart and forbidden. Beliefs and practices which unite into a moral community called church, all those who adhere to them. So in this Durkheim wants to say that all those beliefs and practices which are related to sacred things is called religion. So as per Durkheim, who is a functionalist, you already know that his main area of focus is social fact. So as per Durkheim, religion is nothing but if you are worshipping the God, you are worshipping the society. Because as per Durkheim, you can say that Durkheim is saying that all those beliefs and practices, Durkheim is saying all those beliefs and practices which are related to sacred things. Sacred, you already understand that sacred is means which is related to, connected to the divine being, or which means extraordinary and which invites your reverence and awe. So beliefs and practices which are related to sacred things is called religion. So as per Durkheim, those beliefs and practices which are related to sacred things. Sacred means the one. Sacred means the one which you consider as pure. While profane, so he distinguished between religion. So what he says that religion is comes into picture. So religion comes into picture when there is a separation between sacred and profane. So it consists of beliefs and practices, and it comes into picture when there is separation between sacred and profane. So sacred means any object or anything which invites your reverence. So as per Durkheim, it is nothing but society, because when you are worshipping the god or when you are worshipping the totem, so all the members of the clan, you know, they come together and you know they start worshipping symbol of totem invites their own reverence. So totem symbol is nothing but the symbol of society, because you cannot worship the clan. So because clan is too complex, so you worship the totem, or you can say you worship the society. You worship the totem, which is equivalent to worshipping the society, because it is society or societal power which wants that totem needs to be that invites the awe and reverence from the members of the society or members of the clan. So you can say that it is the society which imposes its collective beliefs upon people and invite awe and reverence towards those symbols which are symbols of clan, or can be called totem. So we will study this theory of Durkheim, religion and society, in detail in chapter 4, in the thinkers chapter. But here you need to understand that as per Durkheim, religion is societal need. So it is a need of society. So previously many of the thinkers, they say that religion is nothing but, you know, worshipping the supernatural. But Durkheim disagrees with this theory, and Durkheim wants to say that it is not supernatural worshipping the supernatural, but it is actually worshipping the society, because it is society which is imposing its need to, you know, integrate the entire all the members of the society, and to, you know, to integrate all the members of the society, a symbol is being formed in the society or in the clan, and which imposes the control as well as the cohesion, imposes social cohesion, or integrates the people, as well as which imposes the social control upon the people. So, and religion comes into picture when there is separation between sacred and profane, because it is sacred. So society is sacred. So people are worshipping the symbol of the clan, and this clan is nothing but society, and this symbol of the clan is nothing but totem. So when you are worshipping the god, or so that is equivalent to you are worshipping the society. And this difference between sacred and profane is your daily activities. So this difference between sacred and profane is there. That's why religion comes into picture, because if sacred is not there, religion cannot be there. So this feelings of awe and reverence towards the sacred, which actually which is the essence of the religion. Okay, so and how a person shows awe and reverence towards the sacred, by means of different rites. So when the members of the clan, you know, they perform different rites, like rituals and ceremonies as a part of the clan. So when they perform these rituals, then only, you know, they come together, and then only the society will be integrated, the members will be integrated in the society. So the rites actually acts as a mediator between the sacred and the profane. and this separation, it should always be separate, and this separation will be mediated. Now, once you understand the meaning of religion, so different you can say sociologists have different definitions or different meaning towards religion. Some of them have says that religion is nothing but the belief in supernatural or a supernatural entity which is over and above the society and which is controlling the entire society and the individuals in the society. But there are many religions, for example Buddhism, which does not believe in any supernatural. So this cannot be universal, cannot be the universal definition of religion. So you can then in quote the definition of religion which is given by Durkheim, which says that religion is nothing but the societal need, or you can say religion is nothing but the beliefs and practices which are imposed by the related to sacred things, and which actually means that the person is the people are worshipping the society as per the societal needs. So it is the societal needs which is which requires the individuals in the society to worship the clan, the totem, and because totem is a symbol of clan and the symbol of the god. So when you are worshipping the totem, you are in turn worshipping the society. In fact, actually you are worshipping the society. So now you should know the functions of religion. So this is the basic meaning of religion you should know, which I already explained. Now you should know the functions of religion. So religion acts as an integrative as well as disintegrative force in society. So previously many of the thinkers they have said that religion is the force which integrates the society. Okay, so but we will also study the disintegrative effects of religion also in this chapter, which is fundamentalism and communalism. And positive in aspects also. We will study the positive as well as the negative aspects of religion. The functions of religion. Now we will study the functions of positive aspects of religion. Okay. So what is the function of religion? So it acts as an integrative force. So you can say integrative force. So here you can quote Durkheim, that as per Durkheim, religion reinforces the collective consciousness, and through this collective consciousness people, you know, so this collective consciousness imposes the collective beliefs and collective feelings in all the people, and due to these collective feelings or collective belief for the people towards this totem or towards the symbol of society or towards the society collective consciousness, people are integrated in society. Here you you can also say this thing, that religion also integrates the society by removing the different ills like of society, like you can say in ills, matlab ills present in a human being, like sins performed by a human being, that sins. Okay, bad things. Okay, so in this way it actually integrates the different people. It also acts as a medium agent of social control. Social control means it controls the individuals in the society. How it controls? Because the virtue, the tenets of virtue, tenet of sin, dharma, okay, good and bad. So it is being defined by religion, and thus it imposes social control on individuals. So people, because need to follow their dharma at every point, therefore it acts as an agent of social control. Okay, then you can say religion also acts as is an agent of social change. Here you can quote Weber, that Weber says that religion acts as a social force inducing capitalism in different societies. So Weber, you can say PSE, Protestant Ethic and Spirit of Capitalism, you can quote. And you can also say that Buddhism, how Buddhism removes Brahmanism supremacy. So it has come into picture to remove the different orthodox feelings, orthodox beliefs present in Hinduism, and removing the Brahmanism, Brahmanic supremacy. Okay, then you can say stress buster, or you can say means of removing anxiety and stress. So here you can say religion acts as the moral force in society. So you can quote Malinowski here, that religion acts as a force, removes the anxiety and the stress in the society. So how to remove the anxiety and stress in society? So we can say that Malinowski says that in the different rituals like birth, death, puberty, in these different ceremony rituals, religion, the tension which is imposed by death, for example, death is removed by religion. Okay. So in this point you can say that in different life crisis situations like birth, marriage, puberty and death, religion removes the anxiety and the stress which could arise in such situations, and in this way it produces the social solidarity. Because how it removes the anxiety in these situations, like for example, death is considered to be the most disruptive life crisis situation in the society. So once a person dies, so a ceremony, ritual ceremony is organized in which the persons, different persons in the society, they came and give solace to the bereaved. Plus it also says that that the soul is immortal, only the body dies and the soul is immortal, and in this way it removes the anxiety and stress. Plus it also helps in removing the anxiety and stress in those situations which a person which is beyond the control of a person. So for example, Malinowski says that, so we will study in detail, but you can say it acts as a means of removing anxiety and stress. Okay, plus you can also say that it also plays a normative role in society, like the different tenets of peace, fraternity and love which is being promoted by religion. So they act as a moral force in the society. So in this way religion acts as a moral force in society and thus imposes the different values and beliefs in society. Like you can say if respecting the elders by touching the feet is an aspect which a religion in a religion religion prescribes, and thus in this way religion a moral value is being imposed in the is being imparted in the individuals, or which is part of socialization. So in this way religion plays a normative role in society. Plus it also you can say it also plays a solace and comforting function. So how it plays a solace and comforting function, because in the events of death, illness, or different issues or different problems, people used to find peace, you know, peace when they, you know, so they always think about that there is a force who is, you know, seeing all these things and controlling all those issues or controlling all these problems, and that force will definitely give the fruit, relevant fruits or positive fruit to person, definitely not today but definitely in future. So in this way religion gives solace and comforting, plays solace and comforting function in society. So these are the major positive functions you can say in society which is played by religion. So in social control I have already explained that by the concepts of sins, virtues, good and bad, religion exerts social control on the individual. So religious institutions like temples and churches also control the behavior, like for example issuing of fatwas by the Muslim community. In this way religion also imposes social control on different individuals. Plus it also supplements scientific knowledge. So this is also a major function of religion, you can say it supplements scientific knowledge. Like you can say when you are doing, you know, Surya Pranayam in morning, most of the people or many of the people, you know, they used to practice or used to perform this exercise in the morning. So this Surya Pranayam is a part of religion, but it actually has a scientific you can say basis also. Doing Surya Pranayam in the morning, it not only enhances one's, you know, it removes different negative energies from one's body, but it also keeps a person healthy. Plus it also, you know, increases the eyesight of a person doing Surya Pranayam. So scientifically it also it is researched, and it the conclusion has came that doing Surya Pranayam definitely enhances one's health and lead a person towards positivity and positivity and good things comes in that person's life. Okay, so in this way you can say it supplements scientific knowledge also. There are many other examples. Religion and science will definitely study these things. So in this way you can see these are the different functions of religion. Now we will start our next topic, which is sociological theories of religion. Okay.